You come at the right time, white man chiefs, representing Kabis, Ekawo. These days we wear our gilets and pillars. In those days, in my childhood days, nobody would dare wear gilet or pillar or put on slippers. Anytime a white man chief, not to talk of, he all by himself, passes. But I'm happy to see that we have the dignity of preserving our past. I was talking of Igaridukon with the upper, the section of it, that's where the chiefs are at, other traditional chiefs, or the title chiefs. That's Igaridukon. That's the link with Benin, the second wave of immigrants to Lagos, to the street. What's it? The school, Holy Trinity Church, and the school are situated. This is definitely Mr. President Chairman, Mr. Lord. A few weeks ago, I heard of Oja Osumu, the month under, and I scratched my head. Those room market, where the hell is those room market? Long story, I learned later that is Agarawu market. Not Yosuku market. Yosuku street starts from Holy Trinity Church, where the knife would be the knife's used to be situated. And hence, at the end of Yosuku street, is on two streets, hence, and still ends at Agarawu's, at Agarawu, on along a Dumbako Avenue. And when you hear of Idumu, that's the meaning lake. Idumako, Idu Shagre, Idu Tapa. Right? Any Idu, Idumako, Idumota. That shows the Benin settlement in Lagos, original settlement, and then the Tapas came. The Tapas, Oshodi, your great grandfather, young man, Tapani. Your head of state, Papa, in order
to please come forward, invite the necessary people as we do the investiture of the number one citizen of Lagos State. And I'm sure the moment this is done, you'll know that it is signed, sealed, and delivered, because you will also come around to wine and unwind with us. Mr. President, please come forward, sir, and let's do Mr. Governor that honor. And immediately after that,
go, we are to remove the circuit Latiman, Latiman to Raka, and make it go no more. By your caps, we shall know you. The governor is seeing the cap on every one of us. Mr. Governor, sir, may I respectfully invite this man?
And blessing to the grand patron and father of the day, Alaiwa, the Pomp of Lagos, Kumari, one, and the Master Mu. You know who himself, for here, they were represented by our title, five captives that are here in large number. Today, I have spoken to have with you three times, and he has said to me that all the children are coming. White captives for Chief Ajose. I want to thank you very much for holding forth for our royal father of the day. They say for you. To all the cabinet members that are here, thank you very much for the support. Members of the Expo of Lagos State, Body of Permanent Secretary, thank you very much. The late celebrant, the President of AGLO, the Eco Club, Mr. Raja Amodu, FNIB, FCIBN, DCIB, let's give a big round of applause for our President. He's working very hard to become a permanent secretary.
The Pomp Club has been the cultural innovator
and it has been a call that has continued to progress for all our nation. Bring together our shared heritage and values. Over the decades, the club has not only fostered social ties, but it has made significant contribution to the development of our communities through various charitable efforts and commitments and enriching lives of people and properties. But I stand here even more proud and happier for the rich history that our chairman has reminded me and all of us. And so when Mr. President came and addressed and said over 50 years ago, the traffic in Lagos, it's good to know that traffic has been in Lagos way before now. And there was no eco bridge there, but the chairman of this event also then reminded us that the eco bridge was actually commissioned during this tenure as the federal minister of works in 1974. So both our club, the eco club, and the eco bridge are celebrating 50th anniversary together. So there's a reason for us to continue to shout blessings. We need to assure all our fathers and our elders in the house that we, the older ones, that they have given this mandate, they have given this sign of responsibility when you started 50 years ago. We will not disappoint you. We will ensure that the undermining ethos and values, the reasons behind the sale of this club 50 years ago, will not go to waste. We want to assure you that the history of the Russians, Omway Kobongo, will be preserved by this club in all facets. Yes, the chairman has also reminded us, he can't go too well, that I think it's important for gentlemen of the press community, that Lagos, as Lagos colony, had been in existence before Nigeria. And as has been rightly said, before the Northern and Southern Protectorate, the colony of Lagos was in existence. So Nigeria that we have today was actually in three parts at that time, and I continue to lay the preaching of it. There was the Lagos colony, there was the Southern Protectorate, and there was the Northern Protectorate. And so that issue, we as a nation must continue to preserve it, must continue to say it to high level, so that people know that we have been in existence and we have been well put together even way before our country. But more importantly, we have also shown that the diversity of Lagos has been way back from their worries to the dangers, to the tapas, to the taros, to the Brazilian defendants, and all of us can lead to the prelude of our Lagos with our Igbo that we're celebrating today. I want to assure you, sir, that that name Igbo will not go into extinction. Lagos will remain Lagos, but the OEAO will continue to serve a purpose in everything that we do as a state and as a people. There are one or two big things that we're going to do with that name. I don't want to lay or open the cap right away now, because we are not wanting all of the approval here. But there's a big institutional discovery that we're going to preach in that name, so that even when we leave the state, that name will continue to be relevant we continue to have a pride of place in our labors and in everything that we stand for. Of the 50 years that the Pomp Club has been in existence, all of the great work that we have done, all of the great minds that have passed through this club, can I make a confession? 31 years ago when I was getting married, you know, we usually have 9 parties. My marriage was at Holy Cross Cathedral, my reception was at the City Hall. But my 9th party was here on the lawn at the Pomp Club 31 years ago. So I have an extraordinary boy, I have a strong passion and an historical connection with the Pomp Club. And today, like our president has said, there is a need for us to look at how to create an ambience where the ingress and outgress of the club will be seamless. And I'm assured you that we'll look at the master layout and see from his requests to us how we can create, without distorting the ecosystem of the neighborhood, an engine and an engine that will make vehicular movement in and around this place easier and more practical. That assurance I have given to the club, and whatever we need to do in terms of improvement, road improvement, to make it work, the state government, your state government, will do it. Apart from the faculty members that are doing our Friday cycling, so they know that once I make the pronouncement, it's for them to come here on Tuesday or Wednesday and begin to see how that pronouncement will receive the necessary approval. But more importantly, we should thank the founders and the leaders of the Pomp Club for your vision, for your tenacity, and for believing in our labors. I want to assure you that where you have taken this club to, the current leadership and all of us who have joined will even take it to a higher level. We'll ensure that the ethos, the belief, and the purpose for which it was held up is restored and even improved upon. We will make a club, a centerpiece of social, cultural diversity that we know ourselves for, that we know our people for. And this is one of the things that we see going forward. And therefore, on behalf of the people and government of Lagos State, we want to thank you once again for being part of the bigger development of Lagos, for being part of the social cultural transformation that we see in Lagos. I will not end this speech without assuring my uncle, my father, the chairman of this event, that nothing is going to happen to Marina. Marina is in trust. Nothing. And I say nothing is happening to Marina. And you always challenge me, you should always do at all times. I want to tell you before. Because you tell me when I'm doing right, and when there are shortcomings, you also acknowledge us. A lot of cleaning up is going to happen in Lagos Island. And we're starting. The market I will demolish with the federal market, which was becoming an eyesore. But we just did not demolish it. We gave them all the necessary compensation. Millions and millions of naira were paid to both the original owners, current owners, to the tenants, to the supporters, and everybody that was in that market. And that was why there was not one single issue around the demolition of the market. And when we demolished, like they say, there were total, there were 10%. The global market as well is also not befitting of the status. That was also said we need to go. The other market that is also on the right hand side, we have started a conversation with them to ensure that it also goes. So that your Lagos will begin the restoration of the Lagos that our chairman talking about. The Bobaka market or the Bobaka foreground, sir. Ogu, Bobaka Keswa Eza. Chairman Wa Kusimi, Primo Lucy, Toyoshi, is one I want to build the market at Kusimu. It is meant to be a recreational playground. We are going to restore it on Blessing! Because you have told me, frankly, and you have said publicly, that it's important for us to ensure that Lagos Island is not only our heritage and our home, we preserve it for children that are even coming behind us. And I am also going to speak up to assure you that all of the training challenges that we have, from Ujogiwa all the way to Ujogiwa, going towards Christmas and Jahara, we are going to do a massive drainage upgrade that you will see the contractors are going to be moving before the end of this year. So we will be seeing a lot of regeneration around Lagos Island. I was trying to require this thing that happened at the supermarket. We're also going to use and form the testament for giving everybody a compensation also for that. And so these are some of the things that we'll be using to regenerate the entire space and land that we have on Lagos Island. We're not unaware of the challenges. We're not unaware of the historical benchmark that it brings to most of you here. I want to assure you that for those of you that a lot of restoration is to come back to Lagos Island. Regarding also our market, see that's also the challenge of prosperity. When prosperity also forms around, it comes with a lot of money. But we try and be organized, we try and be structured there. We are building more modern markets so that we can remove all of the very, very long ways of doing things that we have, so that we can organize them better and we can formalize all of the transactions that we have in there. And more importantly, we are also going to start the integration of the identity and housing estate. Some of the people who will be given cash to move out because some of them have actually gone down. And so we're going to be demolishing some of them because no one needs those houses to go and go down on their head. So the fact of the government is giving way, or money is going to be better, it is for the betterment of all of them. Nobody will be displayed without adequate compensation. If we are going to demolish your house or your flat, we will call that compensation. And the way we are going to do a regeneration and a rebuild, it will be a better showpiece that all of you will do this in power. And so I'm giving you those commitments here today. Before the end of this year, we begin to see massive drainage and road infrastructure all around Yosunu, Dumaku, and all of the Nigerian roads that they see that being dropping school. School to go in the we left on compensation or carried along with any new development wants to. The redevelopment that was done on the late 1998 from Sura all the way to the junction, it was done by the provider. We also want to continue it and take it all the way further down towards the Kalkumon and then to Holy Trinity Church. We're building the biggest children's hospital in the whole of West Africa. The old Martin Children's Hospital, where we built it by the Sulaw market, as you see. The construction that has been coming on them will be the new massive and will be the biggest student per capita student that you have in anywhere in sub-Saharan Africa. It's going to 10 floors, because it's 7 floors already. So the driver is coming, and it's coming very, very, very fast. I want to assure you that this is a different government, this is your government, and we'll do everything to ensure the restoration of our heritage, the restoration of Lagos Island, and the restoration of Lagos City. Once again, Mr. President, I want to congratulate you. I want to thank you for joining the job for us. I want to say that this government will continue to support everything with the Oglot. Thank you very much. Congratulations again on the 50th anniversary.
Thank you very much, Mr. Governor. We will allow Mr. Governor to take his seat for a few minutes.
Arise and shine. Arise, Governor of the state. Arise and shine.
Did I hear you say bless it? And the Executive Council of the Executive Committee and the entire members, I want to specially thank Mr. Governor for this gift. Nothing would have gladdened our hearts more than this. We have almost all the structures to make a good club, but the problem has always been the landscaping. When it rains, everywhere is usually flooded. We thank you and God bless you.
The White Council, we highly invite him to do the cutting of the cake with Mr. Governor.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Governor and the Chairman BOT and the President with the traditional Whitecap Chiefs representing the Oba of Lagos will do us the honor of cutting the anniversary cake after we have all said and spelled the name of our club. So can I have an excellent E? Can I have a knowledgeable K? Can I have a very, very organizational O? What do we have? A O? Thank you very much, a very big round of applause. We invite, we would like to invite Alhaji Motiu Ajao Are with the registration number MN membership number 1349 to please come forward. And we also like to invite one of our founders, founding members of this club, Alhaji Bola Motaji, with the membership number 079. Please, can we please come forward quickly so that we can, Mr. Governor, this illustrious club. And today is being awarded with the club honors of the Grand Commander House of Blessings. So from today, when we write his name, there will be a GCHB. Also, Alhaji Otiu Ajao Are with the membership number 1349 is being awarded with the honor as Commander House of Blessings. Thank you very much, sir.
Yeah. Reward for hard work is more appreciated. The Grand Commander has a place, the highest honor of
of football club. He is a member of his outstanding contribution to the development of the club.
Presently, the Internet Auditor of the Job is currently in the city I'm going to go to the hospital. I am